Yeah, big day, big, big day, big, 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 big day. All right. All right. All right, everybody, welcome to our this is a special bonus for everyone in MBA. Let me start this video. Yeah, this is a special bonus for everyone in MBA tonight. We're coming closer here. Let's see. How do I? There we go. This is a big, huge day. Huge day. Happy New Year, everybody. It's December 30th. And for our regular Wednesday webinar, you know, it was not going to be a TV webinar, but it somehow is going to have a TV element. Okay, this is a annual favorite webinar that I do called CPR, which helps with planning your year. That's what this is really all about. Maybe if I, how do I get more? Maybe I just need to get more light. I don't know. How do I do this? Maybe I'll take away my background so my shoulders don't keep disappearing. That's what I'll do. Did that do it? No? Yeah, maybe that did it. I don't know. Is that what it is? Yeah. Thank you, Allie. All right. Well, this is going to be a special year-end planning webinar for those of you who want to have plans so that you kick ass in the new year. That's what you're going to get tonight, okay? But as a special bonus to that, we have a special guest star on the webinar tonight. Notice he's the man who's smiling the most. I got plenty of women who smile, but a lot of the men, you know, just don't know how to smile. Andres Major is on the webinar. That's great. I don't know if he knows how to smile. But this guy, Paul Neb, he's got a new smiling skill that we've never seen so powerfully as we have today. Ali's like, who is that person and what did he do with Paul Neb? This is what happens, my friends, when your television and celebrity entrepreneurship efforts really pay off. And you know, and I get the same questions all the time. Like, all right, well, how is he going to monetize this? You know, I don't think there's any doubts about how this is a beneficial thing. There's no doubts at all that this is a beneficial thing and that somehow he's going to figure out how to turn this into his advantage. But our friend and hero, Paul Neb, was identified by the Times Square Alliance. Those are the people who do the ball drop in Times Square. And they have named him their hero of the year. He, as you know, he fought me for over a year. He fought me on doing more than a year. I think it was like, yeah, it was probably a year. He fought me for over a year on doing the segment, which was this segment. I got to bring that segment up. And I'm going to share that item on screen. Share screen. I'm going to share this. See, this is what he fought me on. For more than a year, he fought me on 5 mistakes to avoid when you call an ambulance. He wasn't interested in doing that segment. He wanted to do something about computers and technology because that's how he makes money. And believe me, I'm just allowing people to come on the webinar because when we get into the CPR, the planning section of this webinar, you're going to be working and it's all going to be directed at you. But we just had a major, major breakthrough in our community in the body, in the name and body of Paul Neb, okay? Because today I was with him when he was interviewed by CBS New York City. And I've already seen the segment on CBS New York. I've already seen 2 segments about him on CBS New York. At 5 o'clock and 6 o'clock, he'll be on again at 11 p.m. because he is hero of the year for his efforts as a first responding EMT. And I was with him when he was interviewed by NBC News, not NBC New York, NBC News, NBC National for Carson Daly. I was there. And then Allie and I are going to be going with him tomorrow night when he is one of the 39 VIP first responders who's in a special pod in Times Square, because no one's allowed. Yeah, no one's allowed in Times Square. But Paul Nebb is invited to be in Times Square because he's one of 39 VIPs who will be brought there with their guests. And Allie and I are going with him and his cousin Mark. And we got our COVID test today. I can't even believe I did it. I did a COVID passport today. I got a COVID passport. I made a video about receiving my first COVID passport exam. Made the video. Yeah, I think this is it.
Easily enough, I'm getting my first COVID passport. My friend and client, Paul Nebb, is going to be a pretty big superhero tomorrow for Times Square New Year's Eve. And I'm his guest. And I have to get a swab, right? Getting a swab. I am excited because I had COVID in September. So this has to be negative. This is first generation COVID passport issuance. That's what this is.
I got the whole thing. There you go. There I am getting my swab.
All set. All right. How do I find out? Emailed results within 2 hours. Thank you. Agent through the gift shop. Waiting for my friends. That's how it begins, my friends. COVID passport, version 1.0.
Okay, that was my COVID passport test. And here is my thing. Clint Arthur, good to work. See, I'm good to work. I got a COVID passport. Oh, man. These are the things that I would only do because I am accompanying my friend and client, Paul Nebb, into Times Square tomorrow to be part of America honoring him as our hero of the year. That's right. That's right. It's just crazy the way this happens. Now, here's what Paul Nebb, I want to bring on Paul Nebb. Paul, I will ask you to unmute.
Good evening, America.
Hey. Congratulations again. How are you feeling?
I'm feeling great.
After the pizza we had, you must really be feeling good. We had some kosher vegetarian pizza tonight. That was really good.
We did.
Did you get the Krispy Kreme donuts? I wanted to know.
We got the Krispy Kreme.
Okay, very good. Very good. Cousin Mark is a big admirer of Krispy Kreme donuts. And a very nice guy. Hey, were you on the webinar last week?
I think I was the webinar last week.
And when you were on the webinar last week, was that the week that I told everybody that they should go up to TV cameras and ask them what they're doing? Was that the one that I did that? People are nodding their heads. Yeah. So you must have been on that webinar. Let me ask you this, Paul. What happened after we parted ways tonight? When Allie came and met us at the COVID place, she got her COVID passport. So then we all had our COVID passports and you guys went to Krispy Kreme and Allie and I went home. And then what did you do?
I went and stocked some anchors.
And tell everyone what happened.
I said, come back in 20 minutes and we'll put you on the news.
And so, and what happened? What news did you get on? Was that like, you know, backwoods Louisiana news? Was that like Colorado Pixel, Springs? Pixel 11. What was that?
Pixel 11, New York City.
Oh, New York City news. You just went up to a TV camera on the street in New York City, Times Square, and just booked yourself on. They did the interview and now you'll be on WPIX in New York City tonight on the news.
On the news. Although the first one I went to, they're speaking Chinese. They didn't really kind of get what I wanted, but yep, the second one was WPIX.
Fantastic. Fantastic. So,
and after the webinar, I'm going to go try to stalk some more.
Good. 100%. What did you say to them when you stalked them, quote unquote?
I said, hey, you know, I'm here for the Heroes of 2020. I was interviewed earlier. I did a segment for NBC and CBS. And would you like one too?
Very good. Hey guys, today, Paul Neb, I personally witnessed him doing two interviews and he booked himself on a third one, just walking up to the camera, okay? And when I was there, I'm gonna play a special video. I gotta get this video onto my screen here. This was a really great video. I wanna play everyone. This was a really great video. Where is this one?
Oh, the Fox Lady?
Yeah.
Holy shit.
Okay, great. Holy shit. There you go. I'm going to bring this one up here. Do I want that one? Yes, I'm receiving that from my iPhone. All right. Now, look, guys, I know I get a lot of pushback from a lot of you. I don't know why. I really have no idea why anybody would push back on Clint. But for some reason, people push back on Clint and people think they know better. That's the biggest joke of all. People think they know better. And because it's not me, guys. It's not me who knows, okay? There is a special power coming through me. I swear to God, I am here serving messages. And I don't know what the messages are. And I don't know why I've been selected to do this, but there's a special power that comes through me and is here to serve. And when you just do what Clint says, you get magic. You just will get magic. Every single time, not every single time. Thank you for the thumbs up, Barbara. I appreciate that. That's very nice. You know, just do what Clint says and you will get results. You know, why it happens, when it happens, I don't know. How long have we been working together? I got another video I'll play. I'll play a video right now of that. This was a really cool video. All right, let me open this one. Open this one. Open that one. Okay, we're going to start off with this one. And let me do a new share here. I'm going to share this screen. And I'm going to share this screen. Okay, here we go. Watch this video.
2021.
Yeah. Now, Paul, where are we?
Hey, we're in Times Square right in front of the NASDAQ Jumbotron.
Have you been here before?
This is where it all began. Like 3 years ago, I was up there. I spoke inside at NASDAQ. After that, I spoke at West Point, Harvard Club of Boston, CNN, AT&T, Porsche.
Now we did a quick video here, right? When your image was on the Jumbotron, you got to make a little video here. How many times have you done that?
I did that once.
Well, only one time. Okay, now, you just did stand-ups in Times Square, right? Just like this, right? What do you think about the way it all began and where it just ended up and where this little stand-up in front of the Times Square Jumbotron brought you
to CBS New York and NBC National stand-ups in Times Square. How do you feel about that?
You know, it's all got to start somewhere. I'm proud that I can say this is my start, and this is where it continues.
Do you think this was helpful for you, this kind of stuff, this kind of crazy shit with Clint in Times Square?
Crazy shit with Clint? That all adds up.
It's all, you know, those were very wise words, Paul. It's all got to start somewhere. There's a lot of people who never start. You don't have to be great to start, but you got to start if you ever want to be great. And it's all got to start somewhere. And thank God you started when you started and you've done what you've done. Now, let's see. You listed out some of the speaking that you've done. How many times you've been to Celebrity Launchpad now?
Twice. No. Well, two plus the virtual. So
three. Yep. He was a titanium. Now he's a platinum. You've done three different segments, right? We started out with the first segment of yours was
points.
Yeah. How to get free vacations and better vacations on points.
Yeah.
And the second segment was what?
It was the coronavirus computer scams.
Coronavirus computer scams. That was a good one. And the third segment was this one, which was five mistakes to avoid when you call an ambulance. That was great. And then when you do what Clint says, then you end up getting text messages like this. I'll play some of this.
Holy shit. I just got a text message. It's from a lady with Fox Television who wants me.
Read it.
All right. Hi, Paul. This is Victoria English with Fox Television. We would like to potentially have our host, Kelly Osborne, interview in the Times Square audience tomorrow night. Please call me if you can so we can discuss this.
Let's just pause right here. Kelly Osborne. Okay. That's a pretty big name. She is the child of Ozzy Osborne and Sharon Osborne. And she is a jank. She's going to be hosting the Fox New Year's Eve tomorrow night.
And thank you for your service as a first responder.
Good. Call her right now. Put it on speaker.
You want to do an inside somewhere?
Just apologize for the noise. I just got done with an interview for CBS New York, and I'm still in Times Square.
Okay. Hello. Hi, Victoria. This is Paul Nabbitt.
Hi, Paul. How are you?
I'm great. Hey, I apologize for the noise. I just finished an interview with CBS New York. I'm still in Times Square.
You're still in Times Square.
I'm not leaving.
Okay. Now, for those of you who've known Paul Nabb for a while, look at the pictures of Paul Nabb that I've frozen on the screen.
Who are you?
Who is that person? Is that the Paul Nabb that everybody knows, or is that a new person that is emerging from the old chrysalis of Paul Nabb? Yes. And I wanted him to call her back right away, because when producers text you or call you or leave messages for you, you got to be Johnny on the spot. Because like I said with Dr. Oz, you've seen that video. I said, I know they're not waiting for me. You got to get right back on these people. Okay. And we're going to CPRs in a moment. So just hang with me.
So you're in Times Square now?
I am.
Because you're getting tested, that's right.
Well, getting tested, and they had a line of media interviews for me as well.
Okay.
Absolutely.
Okay. Well, I would love to see if I can put you on the list of people we may interview tomorrow.
Sure, of course.
And is it possible, so you worked as an EMT, is that correct?
Yes, I'm an EMT.
Okay.
16 years.
How long have you worked as an EMT?
16 years.
Okay, and what town are you working in as an EMT?
Morganville, New Jersey.
Okay, now look, Paul, whether you realize this or not, this was an audition. And when she said, you work as an EMT, is that correct? Then you should have said, yeah, for the last 16 years, I've had the great privilege of serving my community as an emergency medical technician. I've been on all kinds of calls. I've delivered babies. I've even revived people from the dead. She's trying to get you to speak so that she knows that you can put words together. Okay? Whenever you're on the phone with anybody from the media, you have to talk. They don't want to listen to themselves. They're calling you because they want to hear you. They want to know, are you the solution to my problems? Have I found the person who's going to be my show tomorrow night? That's what they're looking for, okay? Okay, that's my criticism of this little piece of video. But we did get her. We did get you on the phone with her. And, you know, I think she was pretty, I think she was good.
Okay. And so, your story is that the MBA CPR, you had to quarantine several times for your family. Is that correct?
Yes.
How many times did you have to quarantine?
Must have been just weeks on end.
Yeah. What does your family do? They also, will they be with you?
My family is not going to be with me. I'm going to be with a couple of roommates. But, my mother, she's an essential worker as well.
All right. You got talking and that's good. And that's really what they're looking for. They're looking for people who can talk. Here's a nice still from earlier in the day when Paul was being interviewed by CBS. Can you see that? Give me a thumbs up if you can see that. Yes. Good. Yep. That was a nice still that Clint pulled out of a video that I shot of the interview. How do you feel about all this crazy stuff you've been doing with Clint, Paul?
Hey, I love it.
Yep.
And I'm looking forward to, you know what might come tomorrow? We got J-Lo, Gloria Gaynor, and of course, every media outlet in the world.
J-Lo's going to be there?
J-Lo, yeah.
Oh, that means you're going to get a selfie with J-Lo.
I hope so.
No, yeah. See, celebrity selfies begin right here. You need to say, I'm getting a selfie with J-Lo. Say that.
I'm getting a selfie with J-Lo.
There you go. Now you're getting a selfie with J-Lo.
I think Clint's getting a selfie with J-Lo. So that means Paul's getting a selfie with J-Lo.
I'm surely getting a selfie with J-Lo. There was never a doubt about that.
I just got to follow Clint.
Yeah, I guess so. Hey, man, we're very proud of you. And what's your advice to people who themselves would like to become a hero one day for someone in their life, for the people who they can help or share their message with, or for their family, or like you, for America?
Accidents happen.
Accidents happen? This is no freaking accident, man. You made this happen. Let me ask you a question. I don't want to go into the whole background of all of this, but did this just drop out of the sky, or did you make this happen?
I made it happen.
You did make it happen.
And I was persistent about it.
Yeah. Yep. And that is the lesson for everyone, guys. You know, if you don't make stuff happen, I'm going to stop this share right there. If you don't make it happen, it ain't going to happen. I know it's a big, bad world out there. I know that everybody's telling you, stay safe, stay home. But you know what? Home is the most dangerous place of all. Okay, if you have more of a chance of slipping and falling in the shower than you do of catching COVID, you do, okay? Most of the contaminations are taking place where? In the homes. You wanna make stuff happen, you wanna be safe, you wanna make stuff happen, you need to get out of your home, you need to get out in the world, and you need to make it happen, because that's how Paul got this. That's how come Paul has already been on TV multiple times today. That's why Paul's been interviewed by two New York City stations and one national station today, and why he's invited on to Fox National tomorrow, as well as the Times Square Alliance's Times Square feed, okay? Because he went out and he made it happen. And unless you make it happen, nothing is gonna happen. Nothing is gonna happen. Once again, congratulations, Paul. And I hope that everyone will learn and follow your great example and make it happen. And that's what it's all about. Now, that's what the rest of this webinar is all about tonight. The rest of this webinar tonight is about making it happen. Oh, you know what? I really do want to play that video of you from CBS New York. I wonder if I can find that. Paul, is it on YouTube yet? Paul? Oh, there it is. That's CBS, how to do with scam calls. Green room.
No, I didn't get the thing back from TV video clips, but that's the station's website.
How about that little video that you're...
Yeah, I just sent you the thing from the station.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Is it on there?
It's there, yeah.
Oh, let's watch that. Let's watch that. That's
and my brother saw it in LA. They stole the they borrowed the feed.
They put you on in LA too.
Yeah.
All right. Well, let's pause this and I'll do one more share and then we'll get into this. Then we'll get into this CPR planning exercise. Okay. Here you go, everybody.
Bring in the new year tomorrow night.
Yes, and as you'd expect, the celebration will be like unlike any other. It is closed to the public in the area from West 49th Street to West 41st Street from 6th to 8th Avenues. That will be off limits. CBS 2's Dave Collin is live in Times Square now with more on that, Dave.
Natalie and Dick, if you don't have a special invite to the celebration, you are not going to be welcome in Times Square because this is an area with no crowds allowed. This was a ball drop drill. COVID changes many things about the Times Square celebration, but this rehearsal was same as always.
2020 has given us enough surprises, and we don't want any surprises tomorrow.
This Wednesday afternoon preview was a rare chance to see this live. Thursday's event is closed to the public because of COVID. Just select VIP guests with hero first responders. Paul Neb, an EMT from Marlboro, New Jersey, got COVID vaccine Tuesday and a day later was on a bus to the city for this first ever in-person look at New Year's Eve Times Square.
Not only am I representing myself and EMTs from New York, New Jersey, but the United States of America and the world.
This time, 80% fewer officers are being tapped to guard an emptier than usual Times Square.
Although there'll be many less men and women in blue working in Times Square, the NYPD will still have assets similar to what you've seen in the past. There's going to be officers posted in Times Square and in our subways. We're going to have our heavy weapons teams and a counterterrorism overlay.
There are five big hotels in the zone, and those guests will be told to stay inside. Because a very scaled down crowd still means people needing a drink or snack, a few businesses will stay open and see how it goes. Like Mia's Bakery, where Saeed El Wafi works.
I'll still be able to come in at 9 a.m. and wait it out, and around 12, 1 o'clock, like they traditionally do, shut down the streets. If I see that I can't have any guests in here, they're not allowed to come by, then I'll just close down.
Midnight tonight is when access to this area becomes very restricted. The public being told, don't even try it. Live in Times Square, Dave Carlin, CBS 2 News. I wasn't going to.
Yeah, I was cool and warm on the couch, Dave.
Even if it was allowed, I probably wouldn't go. So there. Exactly. But thanks, Dave.
There you go, folks. That's what it looks like to be on CBS New York. And there was Paul Neb. Great job, Paul.
One of 39, right?
One of 39. And thank you for taking me and Allie along with you on your coattails. That should be really a lot of fun.
Can't wait.
Yep. All right, great. Well, I hope everybody enjoyed that little excitement. That's, you know, a really big thing for us. Oh, by the way, Danny DeNovo, I wanted to ask Danny DeNovo to unmute. Are you on there, Danny?
Yep, I'm here.
Hey, you did an appearance today. What number was that?
62.
Number 62. And how long have you been doing TV, Danny DeNovo?
Since March of this year.
Since March of this year. So that's 9 months, 62 television appearances. Folks, COVID has created the opportunity for you to do so much more television than you ever could have possibly done in the past. The question is, who wants it and who doesn't want it? If you want it, you can make stuff happen, especially now because nobody's trying to make anything happen. Nobody's trying to do anything. If you try, you will have so much more success. And that's why we're on, and I want to congratulate Danny DeNovo. Not only did you set the all-time record for the most amount of cold call appearances before your Celebrity Launchpad, how many TV appearances did you do before you came to Celebrity Launchpad, Danny?
19.
19? Is that all? I thought.
Yeah, but you dared me to get my 21 booked before we started, and I did it.
Yep, she booked 21 appearances before coming to the launch pad. Why? Because she wanted it. A lot of people tell me they want to be, you know, my greatest disciple and my greatest, I'm going to give you the best testimonial. Like, I get so many people who come to me and they're like, can I pay you less? I'll give you the best testimonial. I don't need testimonials, okay? What I need are people who have desire. That's what I need. I need people who want to be superstars like Danny DeNovo. And I told you, Danny, when you enrolled, you said, is this going to work? What did I say?
You said I wasn't the worst case you'd ever seen, and that if I did what you told me to do, that I would probably do all right.
I really did have very low prospects for you. I did not have high expectations for you, really. You had no real credibility other than a book that had a lousy cover. Can you believe I talk to clients like this, Barbara House? Can you believe it? No, you can't believe it. But I just tell the truth.
You told me the only client that was worse was someone who you were helping with her English, because English was not her native language.
That's right. And that became Princess Marianne Parker.
Okay.
Okay. Maybe it's the bad ones. Maybe I need more bad clients, because I'm telling you, if you got guts enough to sign up with me and you are, you know, a problem case, then you must have a lot of desire. That must be the case. But congratulations, 63. Thank you so much for being such a great example to everyone of what is possible. And what's your biggest takeaway from this experience, this the past 9 months? What's your biggest takeaway, Danny?
I have a number of takeaways, but I think, you know, Clint, it never really occurred to me that I would ever do anything like this until you suggested it. And so I think just being open to just kind of your world of how you do things and seeing things in a new light really helped me to open my eyes and see what was possible.
Yep. Well, and you in turn have been showing others what is possible. It is possible now in today's day and age with Zoom appearances to do 63 television appearances, even if you have weak credibility and a weak book. The real issue is, how bad do you want it? That's really all that matters. And if any of you guys, I think we have room for 4 more people in our April Celebrity Launch Pad in Acapulco. The Celebrity Launch Pad tuition is normally, you got to get there, you got to have your own hotel, you got to have your own food. In Acapulco, we provide you with a double bed, like a bed, and it's a queen size bed in a double suite. So you'll be sharing a room with one person who will probably become your new BFF, and all the food is included. And it's, you arrive on a Tuesday and you leave on a Monday, and that's all included in tuition. If you want it, text Allie. We have room for, I believe, 4 or 5 more people. I'm not sure the exact number. Please text Allie if you want it. 212-991-8789 is her number. And, you know, just because the event is not until April, as Danny DeNovo has proven, you can get, I'm looking for a new record holder. She booked 21 appearances before she even came to the event. She appeared on 19 before her event. And the event I'm talking about is the live implementation event. That's where I guarantee, if you show up for that event, I guarantee you're going to book yourself on at least 3 appearances, or you get all your money back plus $1,000. And we've never failed. This is why our students have booked more than 5,000, 700 and something television appearances. Again, Allie's phone number is 212-991-8789. Boom, that's Allie. Okay, and if you want it, she will text you an enrollment form, fill it out, and we'll be happy. If you're on this webinar, we will be happy to have you come join us in Acapulco. We also have Acapulco storytelling stuff. And, you know, Paul Neb has done a lot of my speaking events. Again, he said he spoke at NASDAQ, at Harvard Club Boston, at Mercedes, Coca-Cola, Porsche, AT&T, CNN Center. He's done a lot of speaking stuff with me. I would love to get him to do more speaking stuff. He still doesn't like it. You have to get to the point where you love speaking. You have to. If you're not at the point where you love speaking, then you need to come do more training and do more speaking. It's the only way to do it. Being a great speaker is the key to everything. You know, I've been listening to Abraham Lincoln's biography on Audible. This one right here. Really good. 44 hours of Abraham Lincoln. And you know what he was? I didn't realize it. When I used to say, I've done this keynote address called Celebrity Sales Secrets. And I talked about the entertainers in chief. And I used to call Lincoln an entertainer in chief. He was the speaker. Yeah, he was a lawyer, but he would go around and he would give speeches all the time, all the time. You want to have a life, you want the life that you're living to be more so that you can do more and have more. You got to be a better speaker. It's really that simple. And we have another storytelling and speaking event happening January 23rd through 30th. And I think we have 4 or 5 more beds available in that event. Launchpad. CL is, what is it? April what? Celebrity Launchpad is April around the 21st. You're going to arrive on Tuesday and leave on Monday. I don't know what the exact dates matter. It's far enough in the future. Okay. And then we've got the Storytelling Mastermind, which is a full week. You come on Saturday the 23rd and you leave on Saturday the 30th. Those are amazing. And if you can get there, you should get there. Really, you really, really should. So text Ali for that one, okay? And there you go. Let's get on to the CPR work that you all came here to do because it's so important. And I'm gonna put up a whiteboard. Here we go. Can everybody see my whiteboard? Yes? And I'm gonna put at the top of the whiteboard, CPR. And that, can you see that, Paul? Yep, okay, good. All right, I'm gonna make it easier to see even. There we go. And I'm gonna make it. Okay, CPR. This stands for context, purpose, results. And what happens when you do the CPR for your year, this is gonna be 2021 CPR. When you do the CPR for your year, it will radically alter your life in a good way. And the first thing we do is we skip the context because we still need to discover the context. And we skip the purpose because you may or may not have any clue about what your real true purpose is yet. But the next thing is the results. And the question I have for you to start thinking about, I don't want you putting in results yet because I want to give you a little context. Even though I said we're going to skip the context, I want to give you context about your results as a way to think about it. Now, there are several issues when it comes to results. The results are, what do you want to have happen? At the end of the year, what do you want to have happen, right? So you're going to, I advise you to start a new sheet, okay? Either a Word document or you could write it by hand on paper. I'm doing it on screen so you can all see it, but you're going to write out this statement. It is now December 31st, 2021, and I, see? It is now December 31st, 2021, and I. And then after that statement, you're going to start writing results. Like, what are the things that you want to be able to fill in that statement with? Like, and I did this, and I did that, and I achieved this, and I achieved that. See, that's what we're trying to do. We're trying, like, just the way I was saying to Paul earlier in this webinar, I said, Paul, getting a picture with J-Lo starts here, right? I said, I'm getting a selfie with J-Lo. I know I'm getting a selfie with, if I'm in the same room with J-Lo, I'm getting a selfie. It's a lucky thing for J-Lo, I don't sell insurance. That's all I can say. That's a joke, ba-dum-ba. But it's the same thing here. We're doing the same thing for your year. We're doing the same exact thing. We're starting your year in advance right here. It is now December 31st, 2021, and I. And now you're going to start filling in things that you wish you would have done. Don't start yet, because I still want to give you some more context. Now, there are two types of results, and then there's two more types of results. These are two different groups of two types of results. The first type of result is, and this is really the most important one for me, is should I make these like big, hairy, audacious goals? You know how they, BHAGs, right? They call, that's like a buzzword when you're doing planning. Is this a BHAG? Or should these be reasonable, achievable goals? Now, a lot of people think, you know, if your goals aren't scaring you, then they're not big enough. Okay. However, if your goals are too unrealistic, I don't know that they're good. Let me give you a great example. Did you meet Malarama Krishna, Paul? Did you ever meet that girl, Malarama Krishna from Singapore? Was she in your Harvard?
I don't recall.
Okay, so Mala Ramakrishna had never been off the island of Singapore. For those of you who don't know, Singapore is an island, and she had never left the island in her whole life. And then her mentor, who had previously gone to Harvard the year before at one of my events, told her about the Harvard event and enrolled her to come to Harvard. Her mentor was my affiliate. And Mala Ramakrishna, for the first time in her life, got on an airplane. She'd never been on an airplane. She'd never been on a boat off the island. She'd never left the island of Singapore. But the idea of going to Harvard to speak at Harvard was so inspirational to her that she got on a plane for the first time in her life, traveled all the way from Singapore to Boston. She was the only one. She gets there. She's like, where are the other girls from Singapore? And I'm like, you're the only one. She's like, I'm the only one who came. I'm like, no one else came. It was a great year. I think that was our last event at the Harvard Faculty Club. Lucky for her that she was there, because she got to speak at Harvard, at the Harvard Faculty Club on the campus. And that got her in the national newspaper in Singapore. That like blew her up, justifiably so. Why? Because it was the biggest, like it was a life-altering experience for this girl to come all the way to Boston, get on a plane, do something that she had never done before, all by herself, and it changed her whole life. Now, the alternative to that are very achievable goals. Like I remember when I was doing my very first CPR exercise. It was with my buddy on the men's team. This all comes from men's team, men's self-help teams. And I remember talking to this guy, Robert Fruchtbaum. He was my men's team buddy, my team buddy. I said, Robert, what are some of the results that you put down on your CPR? And he goes, well, the first one that I put down is I want to eat 3 meals every day. I said, what? He goes, yeah, I have a hard time maintaining my weight. I'm like, That's a good problem. He goes, no, it's really not. If I don't eat three meals a day, I'll just waste away. It's not healthy. And for me, therefore, eating three meals a day is really big. Now, what could be a smaller result than simply eating three meals a day? I mean, raise your hand if you're on this webinar and you have any problem eating three meals a day. I don't think we get a lot of hands raised on that one, on this webinar. In our society today, nobody is having problems eating three meals a day. And yet this guy who was a very successful guy, you know, one of his top results for the year was eating three meals a day. Along those same lines, one of the best ones I ever did for myself was around that time in those days, I put down, I want to floss my teeth at least 180 times this year. I just wanted to floss my teeth every other day because they say, you know, you go to the dentist all the time. And they're like, are you flossing? I'm like, why are you asking me that question? You know the answer to that freaking question. Look at my teeth. You see I'm not flossing, right? Okay. Now, the year that I put down, I want to floss at least 180 times this year. I made a chart for myself with the numbers 1 through 180 on the chart. And I taped it to the mirror in the bathroom. And every time I would floss my teeth, I would cross one of those numbers off. And I got to the end of the year and I was flossing twice a day to try to catch up, you know? But I'll tell you what, I flossed my teeth 180 times that year, sometimes twice a day, but no one said that was bad. Ted Grundler's gonna have to let me know on that one, but I don't see him on this webinar. And what I wanted to show you here is that you can either be setting massive goals or you could be setting the littlest, tiniest goals. The results that you're going to get, I suggest we're looking for 25 results, but don't start writing yet because I'm telling you, there's more to it, okay? There's more to it. There's two more kinds of results that we need to think about. We've thought about BHAGs, big, hairy, audacious goals. And even those big, hairy, audacious goals, for example, if you were to put down like, my goal for this year is I want to become the president of the United States. There's no way that that's going to happen for anyone on this webinar unless their name is either Joe Biden or Donald Trump, right? Only one of those two guys is going to be the president of the United States. None of us is going to be. It's just not possible. Also, you could put down, I want to go to the moon. That's also a great example of a big, hairy, audacious goal that's just really not even possible. Unless you're Richard Branson or Elon Musk, you have no possibility of going to the moon. And I say, this is only gonna work if all of these results are believable for you. I really think that's important to make your results believable. If you don't believe it's possible, you're not gonna be able to make it true. And yet, it should also be inspirational for you. It should be a life-changing goal. Some of them. I think you should have some that are life-changing, and I think you should have some that are just great. Like, you'll still be the same person if you floss your teeth 180 times or 365 times. You're still going to be Linda Fosdick or Dr. Farah Sultan or Dana Davis. That's not going to change. But you'll have a lot healthier teeth. Okay, the second kind of goal that I want to analyze here, the second type of result. Wow, Sang-Yoon Ju is on here. Awesome. Welcome. The second kind of result I want to put on here, there's either concrete results. Okay, so let's go back here. Results. There's two kinds of results that we want to check out. The first kind is BHAG, and the second kind is easy/doable. Let's just say easy. You just got to do it. Eating three meals a day, just got to do it. Okay. Then the second kind of goals here are concrete or ephemeral. What do I mean by that? Well, a concrete goal is a goal where either you made it or you didn't make it. You know, because you could break it down. You could say, hey, there's the chart on the wall. I only flossed 345 times, not 365 times. I did not make it. As great as my goal was, as easy as it was, I didn't make it. Hey, if I have a chart on there that says I got to eat 3 meals a day, either I did or I didn't. There's no flip-flopping around. Either you make it or you don't. That's the concrete goal. And the concrete goal are measurable goals. The ephemeral goals, however, are not so easy to measure. An ephemeral goal would be, I achieved a closer relationship to my God or higher power. Now, how are you going to measure that? You really can't. You can take some steps to try to make it happen. One of my men on my men's team, he wanted to achieve a closer relationship with his God and have a more spiritual life. And what are some of the things that he did? He scheduled a trip for himself to go to Jerusalem, the holy city. That alone, he felt, got him closer to God and created a more spiritual relationship with himself. Or to have a better relationship with your spouse or child. How can you measure that? It's very hard to measure. However, it's a very worthy goal to have these ephemeral goals, which are not concrete, but which can be so important. That's why, you know, I wanted to have a more amazing relationship with my dog. Now, what I did was, in order to further that goal, I said, I want to have a better relationship with my dog. I put a sub goal on there as a concrete goal. I want to walk my dog every day. See, walking my dog every day helped me to have a better relationship with my dog. So that ephemeral goal was assisted by a concrete goal to help make it happen. You want to have a better relationship with your spouse? Put on there, I want to do date night every Friday night with my spouse. That's going to help you to have a better relationship with your spouse, which is an ephemeral goal, which is very hard to measure. You can measure, did you go on a date every Friday night? Now, one of my favorite ones that I always put on here every time is I want to drink 8 glasses of water every day. That's the Robert Fruchtbaum, I want to eat 3 meals a day, translated into my own thing, because I don't have a problem eating 3 meals a day. Anybody who's come to Acapulco knows there's plenty of food in Acapulco, and we're eating all the time there. Really good, healthy food. But drinking water 8 times a day, that's a whole nother thing. I want to drink 8 glasses of water every day. All right, there you go, folks. Those are the two types of goals. The results, the big, hairy, audacious, and the easy versus the concrete versus the ephemeral. All right, and now what I want to give you is some time, and I want you to go ahead and start writing out your list of results that you want to achieve for when you get to December 31st, 2021, I want you to be able to go over your old list, your old CPR, and pull it out and then check off. Oh, I got that one. Oh, I got that one. I got that one. And we're going to talk about the purpose and then the context. And then I'm going to give you some advice on how to get the best results from your CPR, how to get as many of your results as possible to come true. I have some very deliberate strategies on how to make it happen. Okay, so I'm going to give you some music, and I really suggest what we're looking for is we're looking for 20 to 25 results is the goal. All right, 20 to 25 results is your goal. And I'll put on some music, and you'll have let's see, 4 minutes, no, 6 minutes to work on these results. And I really encourage you, when you're thinking about those big, hairy, audacious goals, go for it. But go for it in a way that you could actually do it. You know, like my number one result that I'm putting on here, number one result, this is a big, hairy, audacious goal. Number one, write Wisdom of the Men in Acapulco. I'm sorry, in Venice, Italy. That's a big, hairy, audacious goal in many ways. Because number one, I don't know if I'll even be able to get into Venice, Italy. And number two, this is the great masterwork of my life. I want to write the Wisdom of the Men this year. I want to make that happen this year. I've been afraid of it for a long time, but I got to do it. And it's going to happen this year. That's the most important one. You'll see, we're going to go through and prioritize them. But this Wisdom of the Men book, many of you know, I've been preparing to write it for 5 years. It's been intimidating me and eluding me for years. It's going to happen this year. Number two for me. I'm going to fill up Acapulco events in January and April. Number three. That would be the Celebrity Launchpad ones and the storytelling ones. Love to have you come down to Acapulco, guys. Those will be full. I'd love to have you there. Number three. I am going to achieve and maintain ideal weight. 185 to 190 pounds. Number four. I'm going to drink 8 glasses. You should be making your own list. You're looking for at least 20 to 25 results right now, folks. I'm going to over-deliver on all MBA commitments. I know we promised you speaking events. We were able somehow to deliver all those December speaking events. If you were at the December speaking events, raise your hand if you had a great time. Rainbow Room is closed. Nothing else going on at the Rainbow Room. We were the last major event that they had. Finished. What else? I am going to, oh my God, this is so great. I am going to sleep until I wake up without an alarm every day. Boom. Seven. I'm going to stress less, right, Dr. Farah? I'm going to stress less than ever before. Yes. These are just examples that I'm using. You need to put your own results that you want. Great. This is separate. I'm going to publish and promote Wisdom of the Men to number one Amazon bestseller. If you're going to write a book, might as well make it a bestseller, right? Waterfall, Terrace, Palapa, and Alley's living dining area. 10. Keep going, guys. Gotta keep going. I'm gonna give you some more time. See what the next story, what the next song is. I'm gonna put on a different song here. I'm gonna put this one on. See, you can't always get what you want, but if you try, you can get what you need. See, and that's really what it's all about. It's like, how much do you need these things to come true? And I'm going to give you strategies to make all of these goals and results become your reality.
I saw her today at the reception. A glass of wine. In her hand, I
I'm
knew she was gonna meet her connection.
11.
At her feet was a footloose man. And I said that you can't always get
you know
what
you that's not
want,
enough.
Honey. You can't always get
I'm gonna be more like Danny DeNova. I want to do 24 national and local TV appearances this year. Why not? I want to be more like Danny DeNova.
A man didn't look pretty ill. We decided that we would have a soda. My favorite flavor is cherry red. I sung my song to my friend Mr. Jimmy. And he said one word to me and that was dead. And I said that you can't always get what you want, honey, and you cannot always get the man that you want, and you cannot always get the man that you want, but if you try sometimes, I just might find,
I You guys are gonna like this one. Producing profit from a mega star-studded event in Las Vegas in May. That's me adding more celebrities to the May event, not just Dog the Bounty Hunter and Bernie Carrick, but more. Why? Because I want it. All right, my friends, try to wrap it up. That's the end of that song. All right, now you don't have to have 23 or 25. You don't need to finish this right now. You can continue to work on it, but let's go on and try to finish up the exercise. What's the purpose? When you look at all of the results that you've put, what is the purpose that emerges for you? For me, See, when Allie and I bought the house in Acapulco, I remember when we got there, it was like October 7th, I think it was. And I said, this is the first day of the rest of our lives. And 2021, we're going to be in Acapulco most of the time. Most of the time. And hopefully you guys are going to come down. You should really come down. I don't know. We still have some beds available for January 23 to 30. If you're not enrolled to come down, you should really do yourself a favor, okay? Give yourself a break. You deserve a break today. So get up and get away to Acapulco. Seeming is very nice. And you deserve to take a vacation in Acapulco. And you deserve to take your speaking to the next level. And I have a feeling the United States of America is going to be a pretty tumultuous place around January 23rd to 30th. You might as well not be here. I'm not. And I'm going to be, the purpose of my life is to start living as next level Clint. Really what that means for me is like, look, I turned 55 this year and I see myself as having like a more mature lifestyle as, you know, that guy. That's the guy that I'm going to be. I'm going to be that guy, which is an elevation of who I've been. Believe it or not. Believe it or not, I'm going to be more. I'm going to do more and I'm going to have more. It's not just a thing for my radio show. It's a real thing. All right. Now that's my purpose. You need to come up with your own purpose. What's the purpose? What are your results showing you as your purpose? Like when you look at your results, why did you write them? What are you going to get out of it? And then the context. Now, what is the context? We used to play this game on the men's team. We used to play a game and it was called What's My Context? And what we would do is we would take one man at a time and one man would go up in front of the team and he would just stand there. The man would just stand. And the rest of the men on the team would have to guess what his context was just by the way he was standing. It's amazing. And, you know, the guy would write down what his context was on a piece of paper and the men would just start guessing what his context was. And I'm telling you, the context is a t-shirt that you wear every single day that says what you're all about, except it doesn't have any words on it. It's like an invisible t-shirt that you wear every day out in the world. Whether you know it or not, you're wearing your context like a t-shirt. And the context is something that you can deliberately set a context. I remember, and this is a great context for any of you who want this context. I wholeheartedly suggest that you get it. And on top of that, I 100% encourage you to get the book, either The Last Year of Your Life or the next version of that, which is the up-leveled version, which is the greatest book of all time. The greatest book of all time. Here's what happened, okay? When I became the leader of the men's team, I said to Allie, you know, the leader of the team announced that we're going to elect a new leader. And I really feel like I should step up to leadership, but I'm afraid. Oh, that's a good one I want to put on here. See how you got to leave some space for yourself, okay? Here we go. You ready for this one? Every time I feel fear, I will remember that when it's scary is when it's great. That's what I said to Brooke Shields. And I really believe it. Because when we were going to buy the house in Acapulco, it was freaking scary. And when I was writing out the giant check, it was a little scary.
I wasn't scared.
Allie wasn't scared, but I was the one who wrote the check. I literally wrote the guy a check out of my bank account. Craziest check I ever wrote.
For the whole amount.
For the whole amount. Yep. And I said to Allie, I'm afraid that if I step up to be the leader of the men's team, that I'm going to be late and I'm going to get fired, or I'm going to screw up in some way, and this will become a negative on my life instead of a positive. And Allie goes, well, if you're afraid, you must. Now, I think I've taken if you're afraid, you must to the next level, Allie. I really think I have. Because if you remember that when it's scary is when it's great, I mean,
That's
next level of if, you know, I got to make a meme of that one. When it's scary is when it's great. I'm going to do that. I'm not going to start living. I'm going to live as next level Clint. I'm going to live as next level Clint. That's my context, to live as next level Clint. I'm going to have to retype this whole whiteboard. See what I do for you guys?
Daphne Naaman's on.
I know. It's great to see Daphne Naaman. All right. That's my purpose. That's my purpose. Now, we still got to get to the context. All right. And when I was the leader of the men's team, I stepped up. I was afraid and I did it anyway. You know, if you're afraid, you must. I remembered that and I said, they go, okay, who wants to step up for leadership? And me and this one other guy raised our hands. We were the only ones who had the guts to step up to be elected the leader. And I'll be damned, the men elected me the team leader. It's the only time I've ever been elected for anything in my whole life. Really. Although I do believe that people vote with their wallets. So I guess I've been elected for millions and millions of things over the years, because people have been very kind in voting with their wallet to join my many, many experiences. And all of you, I'm very grateful to all of you for having participated in those votes. I really am. And I really aspire every day to make everyone feel like they got way more than they bargained for in the process of voting with their wallet for Clint and Allie. So thank you. And when I became the leader of the men's team, the previous leader, who was the shaman of the group, he was our shaman, he was our leader. I'm not a shaman. He was a shaman, this guy. He used to always say, you don't know it yet, but you're already dead. He would say that. I mean, he was saying that for like 6 months. He was saying that to us. And I did not understand what the hell he was talking about. But when I became the leader of the men's team, my mentor said to me, okay, did you do a CPR for your leadership? I got my results and I got my purpose, but I'm not sure about the context yet. He goes, well, you got to have a context. And it flashed into my mind, what if we all lived our lives as if this was going to be the last year of our life, to live as if this was going to be the last year of your life? And I'm telling you guys, I said it to Brooke Shields and Willie Geist on the Today Show. I meant it then, and I mean it exactly now. That has been the superpower that has allowed me to accomplish so much. Living as if it's the last year of your life. Now, we all have heard about, you know, 230,000 people in America who have either died in a motorcycle accident or COVID. We're not sure which one, but it's one of them this year. I want to suggest to you that you should adopt as your context for this year that you're going to live as if it's the last year of your life. If you have not ever done this, you should. And if you want help in doing that, I have a book called The Last Year of Your Life, which you can get on Amazon for $20. Or I have a more advanced version of that book, which is called The Greatest Book of All Time. And you can get that one on Amazon for $99. And it includes me giving you video and audio coaching every single week. If you haven't done it yet, you should do it. And you should live this life as if this year, as if it's going to be the last year of your life, and you'll be amazed. It's a tremendous experience. I'm going to put it there. I mean, to live as if it's the last, I'm going to do it again, year of my life. Because, my friends, you will, nothing you can do will give you that power like that. Live as if it's going to be the last year of your life. I'm going to do it. Yep, I'm going to do it. And I'm going to be using a lot of the exercises. I'm going to go through the book again, even. I'm going to go through the book again. I really had not planned on this. I really had not calculated this out. Where's the damn book?
You took them to Vegas.
I took them to Vegas, huh? Mm-hmm. Well, I was looking for the book. I can't find one. I'm going to get one. Here's what the audio looks like. This is what the cover of the book looks like. And, you know, it's fascinating. That's okay, Allie. That's all right. I'm good. I'm moving on. It's fascinating when, you know, when this book, when The Last Year of Your Life became the greatest book of all time, I said to one of my friends, I said, yeah, I'm taking The Last Year of Your Life and I'm adding some videos and some audios to it. And it's going to be like the greatest book of all time. And he goes, you should call it the greatest book of all time. And I said, wow, that's a great idea. And I bought thegreatestbookofalltime.com. And I made this book into the greatest book of all time. And when it was called the greatest book of all time, I no longer could settle for just adding some videos and some audios. If it was going to be the greatest book of all time, I had to add videos and audios for every day of the, for every week of the year. It would have to be the greatest book of all time. And if you get it on Kindle, if you just click the links in the Kindle and they just pop open as videos and audios on your phone. Then I told this story to the vice president in the meeting at WABC Radio when I was talking to them about getting a radio show. And I said to him at the end, what are we going to call this radio show? And he goes, without even hesitating, he goes, well, the greatest show of all time. It's amazing what happens when you write books. People, like, you know, just take the ride with your life, people. Take the ride. Be the expert. Be the celebrity entrepreneur. Hey, speaking game. If you want to get better as a speaker, get this book, read this book, play this game every day. And if you want to be more of a celebrity entrepreneur and understand celebrity entrepreneurship more, get this book, Celebrity Entrepreneurship. Both of these are available on Amazon. Having your own book will change things for you. You got to have your own book. If you haven't written a book yet, put it on your list. If you haven't been on TV yet, put it on your list. If you haven't spoken yet, you know, we got speaking events scheduled in London this year. Hey, man, you should go to London. I remember Arnold Copelson. You remember, I told you about Arnold Copelson at Carnegie Hall? The first chapter of this book is all about Arnold Copelson. I remember saying to Arnold Copelson, my first day in California, I'm standing by the pool and he's skimming paint off the pool. And I go, good morning. He goes, good morning. And I go, this is my first day in California. He goes, oh, you never been to California before? Welcome to paradise. Sure, you gotta go to New York 3-4 times a year. You gotta go to London a couple times a year. You gotta go to Europe, Cannes. But there's no place better in the world to live than California. Now, it was easy for him to say in the backyard of his multi-million dollar mansion in Beverly Hills. But I tell you what, at that point in his life, he was millions of dollars in debt. He was not the man who would go on to produce 29 studio feature films with the biggest box office stars in the world. He wasn't that man yet. All he had done was produce Porky's, which Ali and I watched the other day, by the way. It was on Amazon Prime. We watched Porky's for free. And he didn't even get a credit in that movie. I'm trying to find out what the story is because it's in his filmography. It has him listed as the executive producer of Porky's. And his son, my best friend for many years, Ev always talked about Porky's as being his dad's first big movie. The number 5 box office draw of 1982 was Porky's. Everybody saw it. If you haven't seen it in a while, it's free on Amazon Prime if you're an Amazon Prime member. And much better than we thought it was going to be. Really a good movie. Watch it. Very, very fun sex comedy. That's what it was. And as I was saying, if you haven't been to London in a while, join us in London. We're going to be having speaking events at the Royal Society of Medicine in London on March 27 at Gordon Ramsay's restaurant in London, and on the 28th and on the 29th at the London Stock Exchange with Nigel Farage, the founder and creator of the Brexit movement, which just went through finally. They finally got Brexited. And if you haven't been to London, you should. You should live as if, I'm telling you guys, leave it all on the table this year. Leave it all out there on the stage. That's what they say. Just leave it all on the stage. Play full out this year. Leave nothing undone. Be afraid of nothing, especially not a failure. Oh, that's a good one. I'm going to put that one on. Look at that, number 24. I will not allow fear of failure to control me or restrict me. Wow, that's a good one I've never done before. I may want to reword that one so it's more positive. I mean, I guess it goes back into the same if you're afraid you must. I don't know. I'm going to look at these all and try to reword them and make them better. But there's my list. There it is. And I'm going to take a screenshot of it because this whole whiteboard thing, I've never done it before and I don't really like it. But I did it for you guys and I hope this was helpful. All right. Well, there you go. That's CPRs. Okay. Your context, your purpose, and results. And I suggest that you adopt as your context, live as if it's the last year of your life and leave nothing on the table. Every time you get offered something, here's another good one. This one is a great one for a lot of you people. Every time I will just say yes. A lot of you say no to opportunities. And I say no to a lot of stuff. Anytime Allie says, Now, Allie, you got to be more careful about offering me food because I'm just going to say yes every time you say, do you want this? Okay. I'm always going to say yes to everything. Please don't use that against me, people. I am always going to say yes. And there you go. Now, what are the strategies to make, you have your lists, okay? You have your results, you have your purpose, and you have your context. What is the strategy to make all of this maximized? How do you maximize your results? I'm gonna stop my share. How do you maximize your results? All right. Well, first of all, you want to reread, you want to read this list as many times as possible. Oh, I want to modify this. Okay, now that we have, there's a modification I got to make here, okay? Now that we have, I got to go back to the whiteboard. Hopefully my whiteboard is still there. Yeah, it's still there. Okay, good. All right, now that we have the results, we change. No, the way it's going to work is, the way you need to look at this stuff is, every time when you read this, okay, you're going to have your CPR and you're going to read it. I would recommend you read it at least once a week, certainly no less than once a month. Make a list, like, you know, right here, you want to put over here, January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, etc., right? And every time you read it, put a check mark. You should read it at least four times a month, once a week. Maybe every Sunday night, you should read this list before you go to bed. And maybe you read it again on Monday morning when you wake up. That'll give you eight readings every month. The more you read this, the more you say to yourself, it is now December 31st, 2021, and you're going to put all of these in past tense, right? You're going to put these all in past tense. So for this one, it will be wrote. I wrote Wisdom of the Men. Okay. In Venice, Italy. I filled up Acapulco events in January and April. I achieved and maintained. You're going to put all these results in the past tense. So that when you read this every time, every week, every month, you're going to be seeing these results in your mind's eye as having already come to pass. Like I said, I'm definitely taking a picture with J-Lo tomorrow night. That's going to happen. I over-delivered on all MBA commitments. I slept until I woke up without an alarm every day, unless I had to catch a flight. I stressed less than ever before. Put them all in the past tense so that when you are reading them, you can say to yourself, okay, this was the last year of my life, and I lived as if I was the next level Clint. It is now December 31st, 2021, and I wrote Wisdom of the Men in Italy, filled up Acapulco events in January and April, achieved to maintain ideal weight of 185 to 190 pounds, drank 8+ glasses of water every day, over-delivered on all MBA commitments, slept in until I woke up without an alarm every day unless I had to catch a flight, stressed less than ever before, published and promoted Wisdom of the Men to number one Amazon bestseller. I want you to know that's not the end of the line for that book. That's just this year's goal. Ultimately, that book, the big, and I did this because I made a decade-long CPR last year when it was going to be the new decade. I made a decade-long CPR. And when I opened it up to be a decade, I was very surprised to see that one of my results was Wisdom of the Men became a Pulitzer Prize winning book. That, and I'm, who's gonna make that happen? Me. Just like Paul made Hero of the Year for Times Square Alliance happen for himself, I now know, I investigated it. I've learned how to nominate a book to be a Pulitzer Prize winner. I've learned how to do that. And my goal is ultimately to make it a Pulitzer Prize winner. Now, that's not going to happen this year, but it's one of the goals, and I'm going to plan it all out so that that book is able to and can win a Pulitzer Prize. Ultimately, I know that New York Times bestsellers are built over time, and I'm going to build that book up by continuing to promote it for years and years. I'm already promoting it. I've already sold some copies of that book. And it's available on, if you're smart, you go to Amazon.com and pick up a copy now for 99 cents. Because it's going to be $100 when it comes out. Let's see, Tamisa, Happy New Year, Patricia. Patricia, Happy New Year to everyone. Wishing magical and exceptional moments in 2021 for everyone. Ciao. Thank you, Clint, as always. Brilliant and love to Ali. Thank you. Hey, look, my last thing is I want to stop the share. I'm going to stop the share. How do I do that? Zoom. There we go. There we go. All right. Are there any technical questions that somebody is dying for me to answer about the CPR process before we wrap things up? Are there any technical questions that people have before I give you my closing remarks and marching orders for the new year? Anybody have any? If you have a technical question about the CPR, please type your question in the chat or type your name in the chat. I'll be happy to invite you to unmute if you have any technical questions. Okay. My biggest piece of marching orders for the new year. You ready for this? This is going to blow you away. You're going to be surprised. Just show up. Just show up. You'll be amazed what can happen if you just show up. Just say yes and show up. You will be amazed at what can happen if you just say yes and show up. What are you laughing at, Allie? He's just, Paul's going to go to Times Square and see if he can get another segment.
And then he's calling ABC, Good Morning America, and Today Show overnight to see if he can get on.
Yeah. Good. Don't forget to drop your credibility. Hey, this is Paul Neb. I'm the Times Square Alliance Hero of the Year, first responding EMT. You might have seen me on a bunch of TV interviews last night. I'll be on the Times Square Alliance main stage tonight. Just wanted to see if there was a producer that I could talk to about coming on the show on January 1st.
All right.
Yeah.
Yeah. Good Morning America actually just got back to me. They're on tape on the 1st.
They're on tape? Great. Yeah. On the 2nd, whatever.
That's what I asked him. I said, you want to do another day?
Yep. What do you care? Any day. Hey, I just live in New Jersey. I can come in all the time. I've been an EMT in my community for 16 years in New Jersey. I've been on all kinds of calls. I've delivered babies. I've even revived people from the dead. Just leave it right there. But you got to talk. They want to hear you talk. They want to hear that you can be the show.
All right, on the show.
Yeah, there you go. That's a third one. Those are my overriding comments, okay? Let's put that on there. Let's put that on the whiteboard. Gosh darn it. I'm going to put it on the whiteboard. share screen, whiteboard. Okay, my three overriding marching orders for 2021. Well, I got another one for you. Got another one. All right, so number one was just say yes. Number two was just show up. Number three is be the show. And number four is have more fun. All right, if we all do those things this year, this will very easily be the best year ever. And what more could you want than the best year ever? Just say yes, just show up, be the show, and have more fun. And you're going to have the most amazing year. And luckily, for many of us, we're all going to share in this shared experience of having the best year ever. And if you're not in it yet, guys, text Allie and get in MBA. You should get in MBA. Text her 212-991-8789 or text me 212-888-2999. That's right. Put that in there. Clint. 212-888-2999. I'll send you the information about MBA. Show up with us and have more fun. And we'll all have an amazing year. It's going to wrap it up, everybody. Happy New Year to everyone. Thank you for taking time out of your life to be with us tonight. Good luck with everything. Stay healthy, stay happy, have more fun. Just say yes, show up, and be the show. Good night, everybody. Thank you. Thank you. Good night, everybody. Happy New Year.
Thank you, guys. See you next year.
Now open up this screenshot. I'm going to open up this screenshot and type on those last pieces that I didn't put. Got to type those pieces that I didn't put. For me. See, I do this for me. Yep. One. Just say yes. Two, just show up. Three, have more fun. Four, be the show. All right. Good night, everybody.